Hello everybody, this is Orange Pit Productions and today I'm going to show you the Nokia 6700 Slide released in 2010. Let's take a look. On the top, we have the 2.5mm audio jack, the micro USB port that is capable of both data syncing as well as charging the device, as well as a 2.5mm Nokia charging port. The left side has nothing of any interest. The right side, we have the two-stage shutter key. On the back, we have the loudspeaker as well as the 5-megapixel autofocus camera that can record VGA resolution videos up to 15 frames per second, accompanied by a dual-tone LED flash. The back cover is made out of aluminium. Removing it, we have access to the BL4CT battery rated at 860 mAh, 3.7 volts, as well as a mini SIM card slot. And on the left, when the battery cover is removed, you gain access to the micro SD card slot. On the front, we have the earpiece itself, as well as the front-facing VGA camera that can be used for both video calls as well as selfies itself. And now this comes to my primary gripe about the phone itself, its build quality. It does look quite attractive from afar itself, but the problem is that the phone is made out of a mixture of aluminium and plastic, so it results in a lot of seams and gaps where it just basically detracts a lot from build quality. As you can see right over here, for instance, it's not even in the terms of the cutting itself. So when you grab it in hand, the build quality isn't as stunning as you might have expected, especially when you compare it to its predecessors, the Nokia 6600 Slide and the 6500 Slide that I have over here, which feel much more seamless in comparison. But again, this phone was only less than 200 euros when it came out in 2010, so perhaps I should cut a bit of slack on Nokia for the build quality on that front. So let's turn it on. Okay, we are now at the home screen of the Nokia 6700 Slide, and even though it doesn't look like it by today's standards, it is actually considered a smartphone because it can do things such as multitasking and getting apps through the App Store, which in this case is called OV App Store. And unfortunately, it no longer exists, but there is a way you can get apps from third-party sources on the internet today, as well as a way to silo it, like as how you do it on Android phones, I suppose. So if you want to multitask, you press at home the home key here, and to close apps, you just simply press the cancel key and you press yes to close it. The home screen contains some sort of primitive widgets such as app shortcuts, calendar entries, as well as setting up your email account. Opening the menu is possible by pressing the home screen itself. You can see that all the apps itself, they are organized into sub-apps of some sorts. Alright, so let's take a look at the ringtones first.
Thank you.
Okay, now let's take a look at the team's next. Now let's take a look at the wallpapers. Next, let's take a look at the games. Now let's take a look at the camera itself. The camera is pretty basic in terms of its interface. You can switch to video mode, have different scene modes if you want a bit more manual control, set the settings for the flash itself, self timer, sequence mode, which may be useful if you want to do some sort of a time lapse in 2010, I suppose. A shortcut to the gallery, as well as additional settings if you want. Alright, so that's about it for the Nokia 6700 slide walkthrough. If you like it, please remember to like, comment and subscribe to my videos and hit the bell icon so that you'll be alerted to every new video that I post, which usually comes once a week. Thank you, and I'll see you soon in the next video.